Hello friends. So to know the mind and the attitude of Francis Bacon, this just one statement made by him would be enough, I think. That is, I have taken all knowledge to be my province. I have taken all knowledge to be my province. The period itself was a period of great intellectual activity and curiosity, the Elizabethan age. And it was a myriad minded age, also known as a nest of singing birds. There was a seat of wisdom, you can say. You will find that in Francis Bacon, the essays. Bacon's essays were published, the first 10 essays in 1597, first 10 essays. And last volume was published in 1612 with 38 in number. And the last one, 1625, all the 58 essays. And in the essays, what we find is, Francis Bacon inaugurates a new era. With Francis Bacon begins philosophical reflections upon life, and that also in the style of Plutarch, the Greek historian, biographer, philosopher, essays. Plutarch's Morals, a massive 5-volume work, wherein Plutarch deals with almost all the subjects under the sun, like virtue, vice, love, Stoic philosophy, then matters relating to government and faith, morals, very famous, 5 volumes. And the Plutarch's Morals was translated. There was a translation industry during, you might have come across Philemon Holland. He's rated as, say, when he compared the contributions made by Shakespeare, he comes equally, historians of literature, they give equal importance to Philemon Holland, who was the great translator of this age. So, and like Morals, as I told you, and the essays of Munday. Another influence on Francis Bacon was Munday, the French essays. But one thing we should, so he has got the, Bacon's mind was Catholic in its range, like Plutarch's. As I already told you, different topics that he dealt with. But you won't find the breezy discursiveness of Mundane. Mundane's essays were discursive in nature, but here it is tight, very tight. And his aim was to discover the fundamental principles of conduct that influence the actions of men. 58 essays he wrote. I told you that is just a product of 30 years of philosophical reflection and reading. 30 years. And the aim was, his objective was to rediscover the fundamental principles of conduct that influence the actions of men. Why people do like this or act like that? And his method was reduced reflection, not discursive reflection, reduced. His essays, we have seen Bacon's essays, reflect his experience of life. But nothing personal, no personal likes and dislikes. That is not the case with Mundane. That's what I said. There is a breezy discursiveness in Mundane you will find. He's more personal than Francis Bacon. And Bacon's essays, you can say, they are austere, very brief to the point of crudeness. They smell the lamb. Historians of literature say, they smell the lamb. Certain essays do come home to men's business and bosoms in a universal. Understand that? And according to Francis Bacon, he said they should last as long as books last. Yesterday also I told you, I quoted this. They should last as long as books last. Very often, you know, you use these expressions like this. Austere, brief, aphoristic, epigrammatic. Reduced, tight. Some of them are crude, so to say, but still they tell you what you would like to listen to. That's the in your life. So he discusses great subjects in a grand manner. Great subjects in a grand manner. These points I have written here. Great subjects in a grand manner. For example, of truth, of death, of great place might have been written by Aristotle. To that level, although he rejected Aristotle's way of enquiry, Aristotle is deductive while Bacon is inductive, that is based on observation and experience. Of friendship, for example, true today as when Bacon lived. All the observations that Bacon made in Of Friendship, in the essay Of Friendship, he has already done these things. And he says, as true today as when Bacon lived. And also of followers and friends. Is the followers and friends closest with this quotation, means with these observations, there is little friendship in the world. True today also. There is little friendship in the world. At least a fall between equals. Because equals, what happens in off envy, we have seen the jealousy travels to the nearest. Or envy travels to the nearest. So in equals, there is no friendship. Which was want to be magnified. That is between superior and inferior, whose fortunes may comprehend the one the other. This is true even today. Written in, say, the 16th century, we are in the 21st century, but this is true even today. So that's why we say, true today as when Bacon lived. So that is universal. Universe. This is that, you know, from this you another point you should also understand. His treachery towards Essex, Earl of Essex, he was his benefactor, but he betrayed him. Understand? That is, this is the mind of the man. The essays of love, of marriage and single life were the product of social conditions in which passion did not necessarily enter into the married relationship, or marriage itself was an affair to be arranged between parties suitably settled. In marriage, a single life. He says that. There's nothing like passion. There's nothing like love. What was important those days was whether the parties are suitably settled. That's all. Nothing else. What we say marriage of convenience. Today we say it's marriage of convenience. So that is, those days it was like that. A good number of marriages in these days also you will find that. Isn't it? So, suitably settled. Some 8 or 10 essays are, of course, obsolete in thought. They are not relevant today. And another point he reveals his mind is, all rising to great place is by a winding stair. Crookedness. If you want to become great, you want the same thing you will find today also. Isn't it? All those people who become great, winding stair, that is, the way snakes move, it's winding, the winding stair. Baker's winding stair runs through the essays of delays, of cunning, and of wisdom for a man's self and followers and friends. So four essays deal with this winding stair, the crooked ways, how to reach the highest point, how to become great, or how to attain great preferments or office in life, positions in life. Four essays of delays, of cunning, of wisdom for a man's self, and followers and friends. Understand? Of seeming wise, another one. It's about Henry Hobart, and who secured the appointment of Attorney General and got it denied for, he secured it but got it denied for Francis Bacon and delayed for about 7 years. He was to become Attorney General instead of Henry Hobart, but he winding ways, he used his winding ways, Henry Hobart. And then not only that, he gained this position, but also he prevented it so that he may not get it. Francis Bacon may not get it. That's what he did. Delayed it for 7 years. Or deformity, another essay. It's about his cousin Robert Cecil, Earl of Salisbury. And also in there you will find reference to that of envy and of cunning. Earl of Salisbury, he was deformed person. Means today we will say physically challenged person. So that's about experience. We have already said it's about his, all his essays reflect his experience of life, not his personal likes and dislikes. And of judicature, another essay. That's also about Cecil, his cousin Robert Cecil. And further you will find three of the essays about recreations. See the topics, there's a Catholic in range, universal, like Plutarch, deals with almost all the subjects that as humans, when we live in this world, we come into contact with. That's it, that's what you have to see. Gardens, in between the things. You have winding ways, you have philosophical reflections on death, on truth, and also you find the of death, of truth, isn't it? So, and then you find that the reflections on relationships between people, how people attain great places, further winding, then it speaks about the winding stair, and in between you will also find that the three essays on recreations. This. And the creation, it appealed to Bacon in the intervals of his busy life and also his statecraft and others. He was terribly busy person. But although he was very busy, he also took interest in recreation. Of gardens, a famous essay, he'll find one. The essay of masks and triumphs grew out of a long experience of writing in lighter way. Don't think that Francis Bacon was all serious. No, don't think that he frowned upon pleasures of life. He had his pleasures of life. So like garden, walking through the garden, he dictated things. Or he went, when a new idea comes to his mind, immediately he would ask the person who follows him, there must be servants, because he is, as I told you, he was a very influential official in the government, very influential person, high officers, he occupied high offices, so he had always assistants. So when a new idea comes to his mind, immediately he will either tell him or jot it down in his, most probably it would be in his pocketbook or something like that. So 30 years, space of 30 years used for writing these essays. And he says, yeah, the essay's mask, as he told him, of building, again, that is his experience of building Verulam house, his own house. It's a palace of gardens, and a fondness for God. And according to him, he said, the purest of human pleasures, that is, what gardens? Gardens, he says, walking, taking a walk along the garden, and also building one up. That is the purest of human pleasures, according to him. Then the greatest refreshment to the spirits of men. Gardens, purest of human pleasures, also the greatest refreshment to the spirits of men. Of regiment of health. He tells us how to preserve one's health. His health as well as our health. And of plantations, he speaks about the early history of the colony of Virginia. Colonizing of Virginia. So you can see the range now. Philosophical topics are there. Then how to come up in life, that is there. Then you have got recreations. You have got health, how to keep your health, how to look after your health, isn't it? And human relations like friendship of followers and friends, and the winding stair, the purest of human pleasures, that is the greatness, the greatest of refreshment to the spirits of men, that is gardening. In these 17 essays about, see, I touched upon today, 17 essays, and the list is given here, you find. So you are, that's what I said, of truth, of death, of faith-based philosophical reflections, of friendship, no followers and friends, the relationship of marriage and single life, the situation those days, not very much, you know, not concerned much about love or passion, but about the whether you are suitable in the position or no. It's a marriage of convenience. And also later subjects. And again, you will find subjects, essays written on gardens, then masks, then envy. That's all how humans, the behavior of humans, psychology of humans. So that's what you find. So we'll continue this. This is only the second of a few lectures that I will be taking. I'm taking it in comparatively in detail, but when you have to do your, you have to answer a question, Bacon, the essays, you can use some of these points, and the main points I have written on the board for you, that is philosophical reflection upon life in the style of Plutarch's morals, discover fundamental principles of conduct, reflect his experience of life but not personal. His essays are austere, brief, aphoristic, epigrammatic, and also great subjects in grand manner he discusses, that is of truth, of the of great place. And about the essay as such, you can say, they come home to men's business and bosom, Catholic in range, already we have seen Catholic universal in range, and reflect his experience of life, but not anything personal, impersonal, nothing about his personal likes and dislikes. And the essays that we have touched upon today, I have written here, and they are of friendship, of followers and friends, of love, marriage and single life, of delays, of cunning, of judicature, of building, of gardens, of masks and triumphs, of wisdom for a man's self, of seeming wise, of envy, of regiment of health. So these are the essays today that we have just touched upon. Just to show the universal, so that is, Catholic in range. Catholic means universal. If you want to write an essay on Bacon's essays are Catholic in range, then you can think about, or you can use these points. So we'll continue this. Hope that these are useful to you. Some information at least you are getting useful to you for answering your questions, university questions. So in that case, you should share it with your friends so that they also can benefit out of this. So till we meet again, bye. Have a nice day. Enjoy your life.